Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Rattle Lessons. Welcome back to another video. Thank you all so much for tuning in. And in today's episode, I'm gonna be going over how many times a day I use fragrance. So make sure to stay tuned. So just to clarify, I do want to direct your attention to the title down below. It does say how many times a day I use fragrance, not how many times a day I wear fragrance. I think one of the general misconceptions is that fragrance is only experienced in the fine fragrance form. So eau de toilette, eau de parfums, extrait de parfum, so on and so forth. And I originally had the idea to do this video a few years back when I was speaking with my father-in-law. So he, my wife and I, we were getting ready to go out and have dinner, and I was wearing a fragrance at the time, and I offered him some. I said, do you want to spray some on? And he says, no, thank you. You know, I'm allergic to fragrance. And that's when I scratched my head a bit, raised an eyebrow and said, well, what do you mean you're allergic to fragrance? Do you break out in hives? What happens to you? He said, no, I start sneezing. And then I thought about it and I said, well, do you wear scented lotion? He says, I do. I said, but don't you light incense around the house? He says, I do. I said, and don't you light candles from time to time as well? He said, I do. So then I started thinking, a lot of times there is this misunderstanding of how ubiquitous and how omnipresent fragrance is. So I kind of challenged myself to come up with the many different ways that I use fragrance in a day. I gathered all my products here in front of me and some below me because they didn't fit on the table. So I thought it would be a fun idea if anybody is watching at home, if you're a fragrance reviewer, for example, another YouTuber, if you would like to copy this idea, sort of do your own twist on it. How many times a day do you use fragrance? I'd be very curious to know. But just know the average person uses fragrance 11 times a day. So let's see if I exceed that. So when I wake up every morning, obviously I take a shower. I always want to feel fresh and clean when I go to work. It puts me in a very good mood. It enhances my confidence. And sometimes I use a Dove or Dial bar of soap. Sometimes I might use something a little bit more higher end. And this, for example, is Santal 33 body wash. So I use my body wash. I love the way that this one smells. I also have Rose 31, which I actually use more right around this time of the year, considering the fact that we are in the midst of spring. But this is how I start my day. So I start my day with one fragrance here. And then when I'm in the shower, I like to use a scrub. So I use a facial scrub. This one contains oatmeal. The brand is St. Ives, and it just leaves my face feeling very exfoliated, very refreshed. I don't have any blemishes, thankfully. And so I use this quite often, but I try not to dry out my skin, so I don't use it every single day. Might use it maybe once or twice a week, and I try to very much so limit the frequency with which I use this. So I use fragrance 2 times. In a day so far. And if I don't sport a beard, of course I'm shaving, and you guys know that both shaving cream and aftershave contain fragrance. But if I'm not shaving, as I'm not now, I am growing a beard out, I use this thing, and this is, the brand is Beer Brand. I purchased this one from Target, and this is my favorite smell from this company. It's called Lumberyard. And coincidentally, I used to work at a hardware store and they had a neighboring lumberyard, and so I'm quite familiar with how it smells. This one has a very strong woodsy aroma. I believe there's a lot of cedar wood in this one. It kind of leaves you feeling like a lumberjack, I guess. And so I really like the way that this one smells, and this is probably my second or third bottle of it. So I use fragrance 3 times a day so far. I also like to use beard oil. And so this is Tom Ford's Oud Wood. And so I don't put this on every single day. Sometimes if I feel like my beard isn't super dried out, sometimes I will use this. And I actually don't use beard oil when it's at this length. I know a lot of people online say it would actually help with itchiness and, you know, mild discomfort that is experienced when growing out a beard after a long time. But I actually wait until the beard gets a little bit longer, and then I use this ionizing brush, and then I use this as well. So that's that. Another way that I use fragrance is through my deodorant. Of course, I hope everybody wears deodorant. The brand that I like to use is Lume. I prefer to use gels. This one doesn't contain any aluminum or anything like that. And I just really like the way that it smells. Something about this particular smell kind of reminds me of like suntan lotion. And so, and that also contains fragrance, but we're talking about on my regular workday, right? Pre-quarantine. And now I put on my clothes. Sometimes if I notice that my shirt is a little bit wrinkled, I will spray on my downy wrinkle release. I'll air it out, I'll stretch it out a little bit just to try to get rid of those stubborn wrinkles. And so this is yet another way that I use fragrance. And then it comes time to the fine fragrance. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different types of fragrances were used before I actually get to the fine fragrance. And this is not my scent of the day today or anything like that, but this is just for display purposes. This is Percival by Parfum de Marly. So then I get in my car and then I drive to work, which is only a few minutes away, thankfully. I have a very short commute, and I think all of us have one of these hanging up in our car, right? So I experience scent when I get in the car via one of these things. And then when I finally get to work, I have one of these things. And this is a plug-in. I think this one is called the Wallflower. So this one is actually available at Bath & Body Works. This is what I use here at home in my bathroom, but at work I use Glade. The scent that I use is called Hawaiian Breeze. It's a scent that I've been using ever since I was a kid. I'm a really big fan of it. So I enter my classroom, it smells like this. On my table, I actually have hand sanitizer, not this one because I acquired this recently. This is the Parfum Vintage hand sanitizer. And coincidentally, this one is unscented, but the one that I have when I go to work is scented. So I do use scented hand sanitizer, as do all of my students and anybody else who comes into my classroom. And one thing that I don't use, but I just sort of want to remind people that there's fragrance in this too, is lotion. Whether we're talking about, you know, hand lotion, body lotion, anything of that matter. I actually don't use lotion because I feel like my skin doesn't get too dry. So I'm very blessed to not have ultra dry hands, although my forearms might get a little bit dry, hence the lack of longevity on some of the fragrances in my collection. But after that, I do wash my hands several times throughout the day, and my hand wash always contains fragrance. I actually prefer to have a hand wash that has fragrance. When I smell my hands afterwards, it kind of makes me feel like it got the job done. And at my job, they actually have this almond scented hand soap that I really enjoy. I have to find out where they source it because I would like it for my own house. So then I'm done at work. I've already used fragrance this many times, and I get home, and many times my scent of the day is no longer jumping off my skin. So I put on my scent of the evening. So here for display purposes, I have Side Effect by Initio Parfum Privé. Gorgeous fragrance, rum, vanilla, boozy, but it's sweet at the same time. I really enjoy wearing this one. And of course, I want to feel like I'm in a cozy environment, so I will oftentimes light a candle. The one that I have here is Tiziana Terenzi. This one actually does contain almond, and I love the way that this one smells. Another one of my favorite candle brands is actually Cyr Trudon. They have some of my favorite smells ever. And I also like to turn on my oil diffuser. Now here's where most people will say this is overkill. Now my living room is pretty big, so when I do light a candle, I can't really smell it in my entire house. So when I do turn on my oil diffuser, sometimes I'll spray fragrance in there. If I do, I'm not gonna light a candle. But if I do have a candle lit, I will oftentimes pick a fragrance that will complement it. Or I'll put something like frankincense just for like the mood enhancing properties, or to make me feel a bit more calm or a bit more at ease or at peace. And so I do often use my oil diffuser, and I have two of those in my house. The next thing that I'll use just to sort of disinfect things is this room spray, but this disappears in 2 minutes, which is why I don't have a problem using this. This one is Sandalwood. I believe the company is apfragrance.com. I just put an order like 2 days ago for four new ones. I actually purchased this for $3.99 at TJ Maxx, but I spray this on my couch. I know it contains alcohol, so in my mind, I'm like, okay, I'm disinfecting and sanitizing my couch at the same time. But the aroma on this is very, very mild, and it disappears in like 3 minutes. So I sprayed this just to sort of remind myself what it smells like, but this is probably the most ineffective product that I have in this entire list. And when my wife is not around, because she does have pretty bad asthma, I like to light incense. And so this is one of my favorite smells, Nag Champa. Just please note that when I do light the incense, I do not light a candle. That is going to be a deadly combination because the smell of the two is quite strong. And I would also like to mention that when I do light candles, I have a candle in every single room of my house, including the bathroom, including the bedroom, including the kitchen, including the living room. So Yeah, I use a lot of candles in my home and I'm always stocked up on candles. And then of course I have a very young daughter at home, and so she's always spilling something, whether it be her apple juice or some sort of a toy that she's playing with. And so I will disinfect. And so here we have Mr. Clean. I actually really like the way that this one smells. None of these things are paid product placements, by the way. This is just what I have purchased and what I use. So I use Mr. Clean, and obviously sometimes when I mop the floor, I do have a Swiffer, so I Swiffer the floor. I don't actually mop the floor, but that has a fragrance in it as well. And when I'm done eating, my wife typically does the cooking, or she has been doing the cooking during quarantine, so I'll be kind enough to wash the dishes. And so this contains fragrance as well. So far, all of these things that I've mentioned contain fragrance. I know it's maybe an eye-opener for a lot of people, but the fragrance industry is quite large. And when I took a tour of all of these factories as the creative director for Navitus Parfum, I realized just how many things they create fragrance for. I thought I was gonna walk in there and it would be nothing but fine fragrance, eau de toilettes, eau de parfums, but they have their own designated areas and stations where they actually work on producing and testing the quality control of various fragrances to be included in many, many different types of products. So obviously, you wanna wear clean clothes, and so your laundry detergent will actually also contain fragrance. And I do use complimentary dryer sheets so that it smells the same as the way that it smells when it comes out fresh from the wash. And then of course you will have to use the bathroom at some point, so you wanna use one of these. And I don't know if you're bougie enough, I guess, you also have one of these. I actually also purchased this from TJ Maxx. I'm not even sure what the brand is. It's called Poop Culture. So there you go. But I know Poopery is one of the more popular ones. And then it's been a long day. I'm getting ready to go to bed, and so I have this air purifier in my bedroom, and I have these scented refills, and I refill it about every week or so, or every 10 days or something like that. And these actually emit a smell as well. And so I actually took the time and I counted, and I use fragrance about 23 times a day. And that's to put it conservatively. There are times when I'll use a different cleaning solution, or there are times when I do decide to put on a little bit of lotion because I've been washing my hands too many times during the quarantine, you know, period, and my skin is starting to crack or whatever. So I just wanted to make this video kind of fun, very quick, didn't require a whole lot of thought, just basically tracking my day, recounting my day and what I do minute by minute. But here is all of the fragrance products. Here are all of the fragrance products that I use in a given day. And I've actually counted, and I use fragrance about 23 times a day, which was a little bit startling to me. I knew I was obsessed with fragrance, but I didn't realize just how often I use it and how addicted I am to it. So I'm just gonna come out there and confess to it. But I'm also curious to know, how many times a day do you use fragrance? If you like this video, if you want me to do something else kind of quirky similar to this in the future, please let me know. I know a lot of us being cooped up is making us lose our minds, so this was actually a lot of fun to produce. And so my wife gave me a little bit of time to myself to make this video. So thank you all so much for tuning in. Let me know, leave a comment down below, how many times a day do you use fragrance? I'd be very interested to hear. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure to support the channel by subscribing to it, and also click on the bell notification and the bell icon in the corner so that you do get notified on future fragrance videos. This way you never miss any of my future uploads. Thanks again for watching. Love you all. We'll see you next time.